We received our solar arch from towerinabox.com. These are the components, the bases that go on the deck, and fittings that go in the tubes, the center attachment plate. So now we have to get measurements from our sketch to see where to cut the length of the bottom of the tubes and if we're going to cut how much off the tops to get the right overall width. Our next step is we assembled it loosely and just taped it and clamped it together to see what the overall height and width is between the bases, and then compare that to what we measured at the boat that we need. And when you order these, you supply the manufacturer with the measurements from your boat, and then he picks out one of the standard models that's close in dimensions to what you need. And then when you get it, you do the final height and width trimming yourself. We've taken our measurements of the height and width and found that we have to cut off 4 inches from the bottom ends of the tubes to lower it, and we need to take off a total of 5.5 inches on the top two. Now that we've cut all the tubes to the right length and we've bolted the upper spacer bracket to the tubes so that we could have something rigid to work with. Now the instructions say to rely just on tape to hold it until your final fit on the boat, but we decided just to drill the 4 inside bolts here, and if they do need to be moved slightly, we can move them and the holes will be hidden still before we drill the final 4 up there. We bought their solar mount kit for this radar arch, which consists of these 4 stainless channels, box channels, and they have some adapter wedges and fasteners and end caps on them, and we told them the size of our 200 watt solar panels, 2 of them, and they supplied the correct length to match the length of the panels. Otherwise you could cut them to length, and we're just trying to work out what the spacing is and where they're going to sit. But we're not going to drill and bolt them here. We have to take it to the boat for a final fit. At this point, we've hoisted the arch up initially with the vang hanging from the boom swung over the side, and now we're taking up the strain on the main halyard. It's probably somewhere around 90 pounds. We've worked out the position where we want the arch and the bases to go. And one thing they tell you is they want you to cut the width of the tubes so that they are 3 to 5 inches wider than the base locations you want to put it on the boat, so that you can pull it in like we did with this boom vang here to give it some preload. And that makes it stiffer and less wobbly once it's bolted down. We've drilled out the holes in the deck for the bases for the 1/4 inch bolts, and then over drilled them, and using these hook tools to pull out the balsa core, and then we'll refill those with thickened epoxy and then re-drill them to make sure we don't have a leak in the future that causes the core to rot. We've taped up the holes from below, and now we're injecting thickened epoxy. we'll re-drill them tomorrow. After cutting these tubes, there's a burr on the inside, so we either take that out using a Dremel or a round file. And then we need to have a drain hole just above this insert height so that any water that gets in through bolt holes or wiring holes on top doesn't just fill up the tube. And since we forgot our center punch today, we've just made one out of a bolt by sharpening the end. Now we've got a mark, we can put a pilot drill hole on the mark, and then we can use a bigger drill for the final. Now that we've marked the deck and lined up the bases where the screw holes will go through the deck, we've taped them together and 5/8 inch up from the end of the pipe, we've got a mark for drilling for a 1/4 inch bolt. The instructions say you can either put in 2 tapped 1/4 inch bolts at 90 degrees apart or just drill right through with a bolt and a nut, which is what we're going to do. We're dry fitting it by securing the bases and then setting up the solar panels, which I've bolted to these frames. Originally I thought they might be stainless, but they're actually thick-walled aluminum that's got a polish on it. We marked where the solar panels are going to go with the blue tape and drilled some holes to pass the solar wire through the frame. So I've attached this plumber's snake and fed that down. We've used the halyard to pull the arch forward, pivoting on the 2 forward bases to get the aft 2 up. And here's the end of the plumber snake coming out, fed a messenger line through the solar exit hole. And then when we pull this snake back up, we'll pull out the messenger line to the top, and then that will attach to these wires to pull back down. Got the wires pulled through now, and we'll feed them through this cable clamps. The instructions say to use epoxy when bolting this foot to the tube here, but since we through bolted it instead of just tapped a couple of short screws into it, it doesn't really require that, so we just put it on with multi-caulk sealant. So we're putting butyl tape onto these bolts underneath the fitting, because if we put them onto the bolt first and push it through the fitting, then it would strip all the butyl off. And we've countersunk the deck so it will hold some butyl and the 4 holes, and then the backing plate here gets caulking. Finished except for connecting the wiring, and I'll show that in a future video.